answer is no to those, then you table that and you wait for a better time, even though you have the right attitude, you have the right time, I mean, you have the right tone, and you have the right text. And so that was the last time. So this time we're dealing with tone. Mm-hmm. We're going to deal with tone first, and then we'll go to text. We want to read the scriptures first, the question, how you want to go into it.
Oh, you can just go into it. I'm going to flow with you. It's fine. Tone definitely matters. Mm-hmm. So, you know, you don't want to go into a conversation with raising your voice, yelling, stern. You know, remember that your spouse is
a person,
is an adult, is a mature, hopefully a mature adult, but nevertheless they are a person that deserve respect. Mm-hmm. Even if, you know, things may not be working out how you wanted to, just know that if you go in yelling at someone, or you go in cussing at someone, or you go in, you know, talking like, yeah, that I don't know what that is. But anyway, that doesn't work. That automatically closes the door and make a person resistant. So, and when it comes to tone, I always say that your attitude is definitely a contributing factor to that tone. So if you are feeling some kind of way, like you may be bitter or resentful towards your spouse, then it'll have a tendency to show up in the tone. And then you can, and I have heard it so many times, wives say, well, I said it soft, I said it nice, you know, but then the husband will pick up the attitude. Mm-hmm. Like, yeah, you said it nice, but I caught that sarcasm. I caught that
or
facetiousness.
Condescending.
Condescending, that is a big one in marriage. Mm-hmm. Yeah, so you know, you little boy and or little girl and your spouse, like that doesn't work, you know. So yeah, we want to definitely work and keep in mind that tone.
So let me give you a couple of scriptures, and then I give you the question on what tone says or ask. Colossians 4:6, and this is the easy to read version. It says, "When you talk, you should always be kind and wise." Mm-hmm. Then you will be able to answer everyone in the way you should. Proverbs 16:24 says, "Kind words are like honey. They are easy to accept and good for your health." Go ahead.
You know what, too? You know, we are sharing. Our mission is to help build and sustain marriages from a biblical perspective. And so Patrick just read two scriptures that's not necessarily married verses, but whenever you see a text that's dealing with how to treat someone else, that does not exclude your husband or your wife.
Correct.
That's an automatically inclusive text.
Right.
Like, it's understood. If I can be nice to my superior at work or my coworkers or a friend or my child, surely this applies to my husband or my wife.
Mm-hmm. And so the question that tone will ask is how to say it. So how am I going to frame this question? So now I have the right text, it's the right timing, but you have the wrong tone. The communication is still going to be off. So if you're listening, you're going to understand that in order to have a successful conversation, whether you're dealing with conflict management or not, all three T's have to be working in order to have a success. Now, we're on here. We're not talking as if though we do it right all the time. That's not the point. The point is not if we're the best at whatever. We're just saying we are practicing. We're saying these are the things that have to be done. So whether we do it good or not, or we are perfect with it, or have it done all the time, it still does not negate the fact that the three T's are very necessary in having a successful
conversation
with
your
spouse.
Yeah,
right. That's good.
Yeah, yeah. And so again, these are tools that we have practiced.
Correct.
And that we have found to be effective when it comes to Patrick and myself, and full transparency, even with our children, even with our clients, even with the church, like all of that, like you learn and you discover that, hey, I could say this better. And before you engage in a conversation or and you begin to communicate, you ask yourself, is this a good question? Is this the right time to ask them before you just put a question out there?
And the truth be told, we know when we're having the wrong tone.
Mm-hmm.
So don't get upset or get sideways when your spouse check you on your tone. Like, you know you're having a bad attitude and you decided to do it on purpose. Like, no, nobody. Yes, you decided to do it on purpose. So if you want the marriage to last long, you got to check your tone.
Yeah, that's good. Nope. I like that. I like that, Patrick. And, yep, you know, the other thing that comes to my mind, too, as it pertains to tone, mm-hmm, it requires you to check yourself constantly.
Your attitude.
Continually. Like, definitely a conversation should be had. Mm-hmm. But then you take into consideration, I had a bad day on today.
Gotcha.
So, yes, it's time and the children sleep. You know, everybody gone. The house is quiet, da-da-da-da-da. But I've been on one all day. Mm-hmm. I've been dealing with conflict and handling and putting out fires all day. I can't say, you know, like, what's coming to my mind is the social battery. Mm-hmm. You know how they say my social battery is low. Yeah. Like, you will know when your energy is off. Mm-hmm. That goes back to the attitude. This is not good. So let's say that a needed conversation needs to be had with your spouse.
If you believe your marriage is in need of coaching, Shamika and I are certified marriage and life coaches. Just log into our website, www.hiswifeherhusband.net, to book your discovery call.
Wives, if you are looking for one-on-one coaching, put his wife in the notes section.
Husbands, if you are looking for one-on-one coaching, put her husband in the notes section.
Husbands and wives, if you are looking for marriage coaching as a couple, put his wife, her husband, in the notes section.
Remember, our purpose is to help you build
and sustain your marriage
from a biblical perspective.
So go on over to www.hiswifeherhusband.net to schedule your discovery call today. We have a very, very challenging day. How could we handle this now? Because now one spouse is not aware that you had a bad day. Mm-hmm. They have come to you for a conversation and to communicate, but you know your attitude is not in the right place. So I would suggest in this case or this scenario that you actually express, honey, I do want to hear. And at this point, if you feel like it's very important for us to engage in this conversation, I don't want you to think that I'm being dismissive, but I just want to listen, like actually state what you will be doing during a conversation. Mm-hmm. Or you could even say, now, if you want me to add or contribute to the conversation with my words, it's been a horrible day today. It's not you. It's just been my day. If you can give me, you know, a couple of minutes or, you know, again, this is hypothetical.
Yes, I think what you're saying is right.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know if anybody that we know is going to say it that clear and proper.
Yeah.
But the sentiment is, hey,
being considerate.
So here's the thing. The problem would be is if the spouse has a bad day at work and the other spouse that's at home really wants to have a conversation.
Mm-hmm.
Now, I have to then within myself take the time to at least hear the full thought,
yeah,
and then say, hey, today has been a real bad day. My social battery is down. Can you give me, like, can we give me 30 minutes to debrief, just kind of calm down,
yeah,
and then we can have the conversation? Because if I have the conversation right now, I might not contribute properly to the conversation. However you want to talk, whatever your talk is, that's respectful to the spouse. You have to communicate that, though.
Mm-hmm. So it's still communicating.
There's nothing that goes on that does not involve communication.
Facts. That's truth. That is so true.
And that goes back. Now I'm thinking. I know it's like infidelity, finances, and communication are the top three.
Mm-hmm.
But even with infidelity, there's some type of communication or non-communication that's happening.
Yep, yep.
Even with the finances, but there's no communication or wrong communication that's happening with the spouses, even with the financial situation. So no matter what you go through as a spouse, you're going to have to learn how to communicate with one another respectfully and properly going forward, because we're always changing.
Always. And you know what? Uh-huh. And even with us changing, then life is changing.
Correct.
Like, and these are non-controllables. You know, like, these are things that we may not have any control over. It happens suddenly.
And that needs to be communicated.
And it needs to be communicated. So true.
Yeah. So anyway, the tone. How do you say what it is? Like, how are you communicating the text? You have the right time. Here's one that I think works well within our marriage.
Okay.
If when there's an issue,
mm-hmm.
Well, that might be text. That's text. Mm-hmm. That's text. We're not gonna go with that one.
Yeah.
But I was about to say, it makes me feel when you're having an issue with your spouse. So mm-hmm. I'll deal with that when it comes to text.
Yeah. And I do want to also address wives when it comes to the kindness. I'm thinking about Proverbs 31, and this is, you know, the text. I want to say it's Proverbs 31, and I want to say it's 16. Forgive me, I don't have my Bible with me, but it's in there. But the Lemuel's mother is encouraging him, giving him the characteristics of a virtuous woman, virtuous wife. And so one of the things that she said is that the law of kindness will be in her mouth. And so you want to make sure, let me say this, as wives, we have a tendency when life has not been kind to us, or it's been unfair, or we have experienced some level of disappointments, that we project that oftentimes through the way we talk. We can become so sharp, and we can be so cutting with our words, especially to the one who gave us the disappointment, where the disappointment came from.
The spouse, the husband.
Yeah, to the husband.
Do you have, off the top of your head, any examples of what could be disappointing?
Okay, so you missed several of my birthdays. You did not.
What do you mean, missed your birthday?
Like, you just didn't acknowledge my life. You didn't say happy birthday. Let's say you didn't tell me happy birthday. You didn't send me flowers. Mm-hmm. You haven't told me how much you appreciate me.
Gotcha.
And then you come to me and you ask me to do something for you. Mm-hmm. Now you asking. All of a sudden, now you paying attention. So it's like those cutting things, like our tone. We can feel a way, and all of a sudden, our tongue is not driven by kindness anymore. I want you to know that my feelings is hurt. Without telling you that it is hurt, you will hear it in my tone that I want to be left alone.
And I know what we're saying. I know every spouse doesn't respond correctly,
mm-hmm.
and I get that. And we're not talking about perfection. We're just saying here are tools that work. So here the wife, she's disappointed.
Yeah.
So
yeah.
I think from the outside you will understand, but inside the husband may not
even see it from her point of view.
Right. This day, he got caught off guard, so he think.
Uh-huh.
But it's been brewing the whole time
within
her.
It's been brewing the whole time. And then, and you know what, something else too? I have heard of husbands saying, well, what's the big deal?
For the full unedited version of the podcast, consider becoming a Patreon member for as little as $5 a month. With the membership, you will gain access to be able to ask questions during a live podcast. So click the link below to join now.